We're going to go into the Word of God this morning, ladies and gentlemen, and we're going to be talking about divine favor in our lives. And today I'll take my time to talk about the description of favor, because that is what you need to understand. I need you to go to the book of Psalms number 5. I'm going to begin there, Psalms number 5, and I'm reading verse number 12. For thou, Lord, will bless the righteous. With what? With favor. Will thou compass him as with a shield? Another version said, for you, O Jehovah, will bless the righteous with favor. You will surround him as with a shield. It is seen here that God is willing to bless the righteous and also protect the righteous with the weapon of favor. And if favor is a weapon, it's going to help you to make sure that all the unfavor men who come near you, the favor of God shall protect you. We can see this kind of favor operating in the life of Daniel. He and all the Israelites were prisoners in Babylon for reasons that can't be explained naturally. Though he had favor with the leaders of the land. Now listen to this. They are in prison. And for a reason you cannot tell. And all the Israelites are there in prison. But there comes an advertisement in Daniel chapter number 1 and verse 9. And the Bible says, now God had brought Daniel into favor and tender love with the prince and the eunuchs. So a time came of an advertisement in the times of adversity. So it doesn't matter the situation where you are, what is gonna take you out or what will be your weapon to survive in the time of adversity, it's gonna be what I call favor. In other accounts, we learn that Daniel had so much favor with the leaders of the land. He was elevated even to a prestigious position in the Babylonian kingdom. Even though the circumstances were stacked against him, Daniel eventually became the prime minister of Babylon. You know, when God's favor comes upon you, it becomes a weapon that fights for you to get to the level and the throne which God has prepared for you. And I need you to understand me, child of God, that God can advertise you in the time of adversity and put you into a place you never thought you could be. Let us look at what favor is, because I'm trying to describe favor to your understanding. Favor is not something you pay for. If you pay for it, it's no longer favor, it becomes a wage. But favor, another word for favor, is grace. And grace is undeserved favor, which means you don't do anything. God, in his own supreme power, decide to lay the hand on you and pull you up. When a man is selected among many qualified counterparts and God decide to take you up alone, that is what we call favor. Oh my God. And you can see the example, child of God, in the book of Esther, chapter number 2, verse 15 to 17. The Bible tells me very clearly there that Esther was selected among several other beautiful ladies that are qualified to be queens. Ooh. And you need to know, Esther was not even from that country. She was also an orphan. So she had all the disadvantages in life. But favor is more powerful than any competitor. Favor is more powerful than any competition. When favor comes, favor is a weapon. And I pray that favor shall fight for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. As we are in the month of favor and grace, I declare that you shall be selected among many.